disease is the biggest killer in the world. In fact, 1 in 4 of us will die from it. And that's quite frightening when you look around this room and think just how many of us will be affected by this. If it's not you yourself, then it could be your family, your friends, or your colleagues. And it could strike at any time. Imagine if somebody in this room had a heart attack right now. What would you do? Well, hopefully you'd call an ambulance, because getting to the hospital for treatment as quickly as possible is absolutely essential. So a heart attack is caused by a sudden loss of blood supply to the heart, and the heart starts to die in the absence of oxygen. And at hospital, that blood supply is restored as quickly as possible to prevent ongoing damage to the heart. And as I said, this is absolutely essential for survival. However, and maybe you knew that, but did you know that that process of restoring the blood supply to the heart actually causes additional damage on top of the heart attack, and that that will also contribute to poor heart function afterwards? And so clearly we need better treatments for heart attacks, and that's where my project comes in. I'm looking at the role of a particular gene called RUNX1 in the heart. And this gene is switched on after a heart attack, and we think that it acts like a switchboard and turns on some genes and turns off others, and that this drives the response of the heart after a heart attack, leading to poor heart function. And to look at this, we've been using a specific type of mouse that is deficient in the RUNX1 gene. And it's like, if you bake a cake and you miss out the sugar, you realize that the sugar provides a sweetness to that cake. And here, we're looking at mice that are deficient in the RUNX1 gene in the hope that that will tell us about what RUNX1 does in the heart. And amazingly, these mice had much better function after a heart attack than mice that have a normal level of the RUNX1 gene. And remarkably, their heart function is pretty similar to how it was before they even had a heart attack. And so now, I want to know, what is it that causes RUNX1 to switch on after a heart attack? And how exactly does that lead to poor heart function? And to do this, I'm going to be looking at cells and hearts from these RUNX1 deficient mice. Because if we can answer these questions, then perhaps in the future, we could design better treatments for heart attacks, maybe targeting RUNX1. And then, perhaps in the future, if someone in this room was to have a heart attack, we'd have a better recovery.